We continue from our previous demo where we were looking at our travel and expense spend from our kickoff meeting. So I'm the financial controller, and I want to look deeper into the company's overall travel and expense spend. So to do this, I'm going to go to SAP Spend Control Tower, a new solution that uses advanced AI features and the ability to see spend across your organization to help uncover cost-saving opportunities and discover process improvements. So I'm going to start on my dashboard, and the first thing I notice is that I've consolidated my spend across applications such as S4HANA, SAP Concur, Fieldglass, and SAP Ariba. But I really want to keep track of the spend that was incurred on the recent kickoff meeting. So I go to my travel and expense dashboard, and sure enough, I see the travel expenses have increased after the workshop, and if I delve a little bit deeper, I can see that they're slightly higher than we originally budgeted. I can also see the main suppliers that were used, and also a breakdown of the spend by category and also by expense type for the workshop. So like most companies, we all strive to become low-carbon companies, and today we want to set some achievement targets for 2040. But to do this, I need to track my emissions very closely. So for this, we're going to go to our sustainability dashboard, which show our Scope 3 emissions. What people don't know is the SAP Spend Control Tower natively integrates with SAP Sustainability Footprint Management, and this provides us with the carbon emission data we need. So here on the dashboard, I want to identify emission hotspots, but immediately I realize there is a significant amount of carbon data missing from our dashboard. But luckily, we have a brand new GenAI capability that can generate the missing carbon emissions for us. So here now we can see a baseline report for all carbon emissions across my spend. It also estimated emissions to all categories, hierarchies, and suppliers. So now I'm able to identify the top suppliers and the top products that are contributing overall to our emissions, and I can start to take steps to address this in order to meet our 2040 target. Okay, so now we have a handle on the company's footprint for spend. But what if I want to take an even wider look at our carbon emissions across our company? For example, taking a look at our overall supply chain. So to do this, we're going to go to SAP Datasphere. And with its open data ecosystem, it is the foundation for a business data fabric. It equips any organization to deliver meaningful data to every data consumer while keeping the business context and the logic intact. So again, I want to understand the carbon emissions we are generating through our deliveries. But to do this, I need information on how much CO2 is generated by different modes of transportation. So to do this, we're going to go to SAP Datasphere Catalog. The catalog gives a single view of all the data artifacts across our system. We can use it to discover, organize, and curate the data based on our business needs. And here you can see we have very different kinds of objects, such as assets, KPIs, and data products. Well, what's important to mention here is it's not just SAP data sources we're looking at here. This also gives you access to trusted third-party industry data from thousands of providers. So in this scenario, I'm going to import a data product for carbon dioxide emissions from different transport types. So here we can see it has information on transport types, different routes, and the relative emissions. So next, I'm going to go to my data builder. And here we can see my delivery flow coming from S4HANA. Now, I'm going to enrich this data flow for deliveries with the brand new emissions information that I've gotten from my dashboard. So with traditional dashboards and data models, we can ask very structured questions and get structured answers. So earlier we saw our sustainability dashboard with the structured information. But sometimes we want to ask open-ended questions. So for example, what areas of my business should I focus on to lower our carbon emissions? To answer such questions, we're going to go to SAP Datasphere Knowledge Graph. SAP Datasphere Knowledge Graph aims to provide organizations with a comprehensive understanding of their landscape. However, creating knowledge graphs manually from scratch is very costly. So SAP Datasphere comes to help by automatically pre-populating them using content already available in SAP Datasphere, like connections to source systems, tables, and foreign keys. So as the data is onboarded and integrated into SAP Datasphere, it automatically creates an ontology representing the relationships in the data, including the business context from sources like S4HANA. Knowledge Graph does all of this behind the scenes and enables AI to answer complex and open-ended questions. So let's take a look. So here again, we see Joule, SAP's co-pilot, and we're going to ask a question. So I'm going to ask, which delivery routes and delivery modes have the highest carbon emissions. So straight away, I can see my intra-city deliveries feature multiple times. So I'm going to ask Jule another question. I'm going to ask him to show me emission by transport modes. And this time, I would like to see it in a chart. What we can see here is that our intra-city routes in large congested cities are contributing significantly to our carbon footprint. So perhaps to reach our targets, we should electrify our intra-city delivery fleet over the coming years. OK, so now we've seen SAP Spend Control Tower. We've seen Datasphere and gone deeper into Catalog, Data Builder, and also we've seen our Knowledge Graph with Jule. But this is just a glimpse of some of the great AI features we are integrating into our data and analytics portfolio.